This is an interesting bond pick. For dying.
But you keep listening, and presently they sound as if they're the same for me. What's the matter?
A young woman wants to see you, sir.
A young woman? What does she want?
Well, sir, she says you'll be quite glad to see her when you know when she's come about. She's quite a common girl, sir. Very common indeed. I should have sent her away, only I thought perhaps you would like her to talk into some of your machines. I hope I've not done wrong, sir. It's just you see such queer people sometimes. You'll excuse me, I'm sure.
Oh, that's all right, Miss Pierce. Has she an interesting accent?
Oh, something dreadful, sir, really. I don't know how you could take an interest in it.
Let's have her up. Show her up, Miss Pierce.
Very well, it's for you to say.
This is rather beautiful, darling. I can show you how it works. We're set of talking, and I'll quote her first embellishment speech. Then you bother a bit. And then we'll get her on the phonograph. You can turn her on as often as you like, with her in transit before him.
Young woman, sir.
Why, this is the young girl I took her down last night. She's no use to me. I've all the records I want for this engraving hill, and I won't waste another cylinder on it. Be off with you. I don't want you.
You saucy.
You ain't here when I come and bore ya.
Did you tell him I come in a taxi?
Nonsense, girl. What do you think a gentleman like Mr. Higgins cares for cheeky?
We are proud, aren't we? He never given lessons, not him. I heard him say, sir, Will. I ain't come to have any compliment. If my mother's not good enough, I can go elsewhere.
Good enough for what?
Good enough for you now, you idiot. So I come to have lessons by you. I'll take her to make a mistake.
Well, what do you expect me to say to you?
You're a gentleman, I think you might ask me to sit down, don't I tell you I'm bringing you business?
Pickering, shall we ask this baggage to sit down, or shall we throw her out the window?
Oh, you call that baggage, why well, I'll be the pay like any lady.
How much?
Oh, now I thought you'd come off when you got a chance to find a bit of what you chucked that in last night. You had a drop in, hadn't you?
Oh, sit down.
We're going to make a compliment on it.
Sit down.
Sit down, girl. Where's your toes?
Oh. Won't you sit down?
What's your name?
Eliza, do you let off?
Eliza. Elizabeth. Betsy and Bess. They went to the woods to find a pair's nests.
They found a nest with four eggs in it.
They took one apiece and left three.
Don't be silly. You mustn't speak to a gentleman like that.
Oh, I won't speak.
How much do you propose to pay for the lessons?
Oh, I know what's right. A local friend of mine gets French lessons from a real French gentleman, £8 an hour, Will. To another place to ask me to pay the same for teaching my own language as you would for teaching French, so I will pay you more than a shilling.
Take it off, Luther.
You take a shilling, not a simple shilling, but as a percentage of this girl's income, it comes out to be fully equivalent to 60 or 70 guineas from Milkman.
Perhaps so.
Figure it out. A millionaire makes now £150 a day. She earns about half a crown.
Told you I
should be 2/5 of her day's income for a lesson. 2/5 of a millionaire's income would be somewhere about £60. It's handsome. Oh, George, it's enormous. It's a large top like a hat.
60 pounds? What are you talking about? 60 pounds? I never said.
Your tongue.
Greatest teacher alive, if you can make that happen. I'll bet you all the expenses of the experiment that you can't do it. And I'll pay for the lessons.
You are good, Captain, thank you.
It's almost irresistible. She's so deliciously low. So horribly dirty.
Oh, I am dirty. I wash my face and my hands before I come here. I did.
You're certainly not going to turn the head of flattery.
Oh, don't say that, sir. There's more ways of one than turning a girl's head, and nobody can do it better than Mr. Higgins. Though he may not always mean it. I do hope, sir, you won't encourage him to do anything foolish.
What is life? What are series of inspired follies? The trouble is in finding a clue. Never lose a chance. They don't come every day. I shall make a duchess of this. Dragon-tailed gutter's knife. Yes, in 6 months. In 3 inches, Cordier in a quick tart. I'll take her anywhere and pass her off as anything. We'll start today. Now, this moment. Take her away to the bath, Mrs. Pierce. Clean her. Monkey brand if you don't come off any other way. Is there a good fire in the kitchen?
Yes, but.
Take off all her clothes and burn them. Bring up white or something for new ones. Wrap her up in brown paper when they come.
Oh, you ain't no gentleman. It's not the same thing as your mom. I'm a good girl. I'm not gonna let you
off. We want none of your missing clothes. Here, young woman, you've got to start behaving like a duchess. Take her away, Mrs. Pierce. If she gives you any trouble, wallop her.
I'll call the police, shall we?
Okay, no place to put her.
I'll put her in the dustbin.
Be reasonable. You must be reasonable, Mr. Higgins. Really, you must. You can't walk over everybody like this.
I walk over everybody. My dear Mrs. Pierce, my dear Pickering, I never intended to walk over anyone. All I propose that we be kind to this poor girl, so that she'll be better prepared for herself for a new station in life. If I do not express myself clearly, it is because I do not wish you her a delicacy, or yours.